And welcome to Birmingham, a city located in the heart of England. We're here at the Barclaycard Arena for finals day at the Yonex All England Championships, the oldest international tournament in world badminton. It's an event that is steeped in history, and today the players will do battle for the right to lift the prestigious trophies at the 105th All England Championships. Such is the history and tradition, this event is widely regarded in a similar way to the status of Wimbledon in the world of tennis. It's therefore an event all the players desperately want to win. Well, this year we've had a change in the international calendar. 2 months without a Super Series, and therefore the All England is the first event on the 12 tournament MetLife BWF World Super Series. Not only the first event, but also the first of 5 premier events, an even higher tier of tournament within the Super Series. And as you can see, at the end of the year, we have the Super Series finals, destination Dubai for the top 8 players and pairs in each of the 5 disciplines. And my goodness, what a success the first destination Dubai Super Series finals were last year. Remember, of course, it's only the results from the 12 Super Series events that count towards the qualification process. And because of the success in 2014, the players are already talking about the qualification for this year's destination Dubai World Super Series finals. Well, as I say, it is finals day today, and we're starting with mixed doubles, and the third consecutive year these two pairs are meeting in the final. The world and Olympic champions Jiang Nang and Zhao Yunlei up against the 3-time defending champions Akbar dan Nasir from Indonesia. In the women's singles, history will be made because never before has a player from either India or Spain lifted the trophy. Saina Nehwal, the Olympic bronze medalist, up against Carolina Marin, the European and world champion. They're men's singles and the only final to feature the number 1 and 2 seeds. The world champion Chen Long up against the European champion Yanor Jorgensen. Then an all-Chinese women's doubles final. Wang Xiaoli and Yu Yang, the defending champions and 3-time winners in their 5th consecutive All England final, up against a new pair of Bao Yixin and Tan Kyuan-ting. Then we finish with men's doubles and 2 Olympic champions playing together, Fu Haifeng and Jiang Nan. They're up against the Olympic silver medalists and 2011 winners, Matthias Bo and Carsten Mogensen. So we're ready for the first of our finals. It is the world and Olympic champions, Jiang Nan and Zhao Yunlei of China, up against the 3-time defending champions, Tontowi Ahmad and Liliana Nasir of Indonesia. Let's go courtside and join our MC to get the players onto court, Howard Bentham.
Time to welcome the players. Let's hear it for the number 1 seed from China.
so the defending champions are looking to achieve a fourth All-England Championship. Tintoy Ahmad and Liliana Nasir, a fourth consecutive. Well, that hasn't been done since Donald Hume and Betty Yuba between 1933 and 1936. These two pairs, dominance in world badminton, have achieved so much. And of course, it's the third consecutive year that these two pairs meet in the All England final. Last year between them, they won 7 of the 12 Super Series events. That's how dominant they've been. And Olympic champions, number one seed Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei, appearing in their fourth All England mixed doubles final. Of course, they were champions, having come through the qualifying back in 2010. Last year, an incredible year, 8 finals from 12 tournaments played.
If we can just remind you, please, ladies and gentlemen,
here in this year's championships, well, they had a bit of a battle in the quarterfinal against the number 5 seeds, Gosun Kyung and Kim Ha Na, but it was still 2 straight games. In fact, they had to come back from 11-16 down in the second, saved a game point, but as you can see, all 4 matches in 2 straight games. Their opponents, the number 4 seeds from Indonesia, Tintoy Ahmad, the 27-year-old, and Liliana Nasir, 29. For Liliana Nasir, this is her 6th All England mixed doubles final, her 4th, of course, with her partner of today, because they are the 3-time defending champions. Well, as you can see, 4 in the world, and as far as their path through to today's final, their quarterfinal against the English pair, the married couple of Chris and Gabby Adcock, the number 6 seeds, they were pushed the full distance. What a thrilling match that was, 1 hour and 4 minutes. Yesterday, they defeated the number 2 seeds, Joachim Fischer-Nielsen and Christina Pedersen, in 2 straight games. And I have to say, I thought yesterday they looked very, very sharp indeed. Well, this will be the 12th meeting between these two pairs. Well, that, in fact, was the last ranking tournament that he played. The last time they actually played was in the final of the Asian Games, which, of course, unlike the All England final last year, at the Asian Games, it was the Chinese pair that won and took the gold medal. And in fact, they won in 2 straight games, 21-16, 21-14. So for Zhao Yunlei, an incredible 8th All England final. She's contested 4 women's doubles finals, winning the title in 2012, and this her 4th mixed doubles final. So the umpire, Mike Wright from England, Christoph Oswald from Germany, is our service judge. Of Indonesian fans in and plenty of Chinese fans. I saw them all standing outside queuing before the doors were open at the Barclaycard Arena.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Liliana Nasir and Tintoy Ahmad, Indonesia. And on my left, Zhao Yunlei and Zhang Nan, China. Liliana Nasir to serve to Zhang Nan. Love all. Play.
So So the defending champions looking for a fourth consecutive title. Far side of the court as we look down to Tony Ahmad and Liana Nasir. Pleasure of watching Tantowi Ahmad and Liana Nasir over the last couple of rounds. How much do you think this final and the outcome is going to be between the two female players on court? Who can control the net area the better?
Yeah, I think it's going to be pretty important who wins the net. Very crucial for at least the Indonesian player that Liana Nasir can match Jiayun Lei at the net. I hold Jiang Nan as a little bit of a better mixed doubles player as compared to Tantowi Ahmad. Ahmad is really, really strong in his attacking game, as we see here. So, in order to succeed, Liana Nasir needs to create the possibilities for him at the net. I think the Chinese pair, Jiayun Lei and Jiang Nan, can play both defense and offense very well. So I think we can survive a little bit longer in the defense than will be the case with the Indonesians.
Decision on the return of serve. Now I've noticed something very interesting as well, Steen, on the Chinese coaching bench. Because the head coach, Li Yongbo, that very, very rarely is seen courtside these days, is sitting there. He obviously feels this is very, very important. There he is, nearest to us, head coach Li Yongbo. Former England champion himself, women's doubles. Three times, in fact.
And he probably feels that the Indonesian pair is the biggest threat to China dominance in the mixed doubles department right now.
Oh, it was such a good serve from Jiang Nan, 25-year-old from Beijing. Got his partner involved right from the start of the rally. Have started this final. They've obviously come on with the mindset that attack and more attack. Get the shuttle going in a downward direction.
Yeah, they don't want to let the Indonesians sort of get their strong play going. They want to try to control the match from the beginning, and you can see Jiayun Lei was also challenging at the net.
For Widi Anto, the Indonesian coach, and of course former partner of Liana Nasir. Liana Nasir reached two All England finals, 2008 and 2010. He's a bit like Sir Alex Ferguson, isn't he, with a chewing while he's watching his players. Oh, what a super return! Now, we'll probably see a lot of that when we've seen the little use of the mid-court area, try and get it past the front-court player, but the shuttle's still landing in front of the rear-court player.
Yeah, I think both pair will try to use the mid-court, and this is where I think that Jiang Nan is quite a bit better than Tong Chou Wei Mat. Mat has his strength above the tape, whereas Jiang Nan can also play the creative shots from below the tape.
Just brushing the shuttle off. That, in fact, it hadn't come out of its tumble. That is fantastic racket head control. Oh, my goodness. Oh, Jiang Nan had no right to get that first one back.
Service over. 3-10.
You can see that she tries actually to get it just past Liliana Natsir. Gets a little bit too short, and of course it's an easy kill. But as a mixed double net player, you simply have to be allowed to make mistakes in order to be creative enough.
Broken strings. Yeah, he does create nice angles, and I understand exactly what you mean, Steen, about his attacking play. Creative, but not likewise on his defence. Herself.
No, it was too far wide for a player of that caliber.
Yes, I'm talking of caliber. I mean, she is double Olympic champion,
interval.
Double world champion, reigning in both.
Coach, leave the court.
Yeah, well, Liliana Natsir having just as much say as Coach Nova Woodyanto, I think that she is vastly experienced.
And interesting that Li Yongbo had so much to say here. I mean, the players are 11-5 up, and still he was doing a lot of talking in this interval, so it's probably some general thing that they're working on that he's trying to emphasize here in the interval.
It's over. 6-11.
Yeah, it's that lovely use of the mid-court area. What a net shot from Tantori Ahmad.
7-11.
Considering they won 8 down at one stage, this is a very good comeback. All of a sudden, it's believable that they can win this opening game. Still a long way to go, I know that, but all of a sudden, there's belief as well in the body language. Oh, it's landed in. She could have played that. No, it's not bad, a backup coach, double Olympic champion, Jang Jun, sitting beside Lee Yongbo.
And he's been coaching in many, many important finals as well.
Yeah. Yesterday, Steen, that if you're going to attack against the Indonesian pair, probably not a good idea to attack on Liliana Nasir, because she's actually got more creative defence than her partner.
Yeah, there's a bigger chance that she will turn the defence around than Tonto Wiamat doing the same thing. The Indonesians, the last three rallies here, they came out strong after the interval, and I think they've discussed moving a little bit closer to the net, covering the front court very well, because they know, or they should know, that the Chinese won't lift voluntarily.
Gone again, I think, in the racket. Or was that just a complete miss hit?
15-8.
It was just a complete miss hit. Threw his racket down in frustration. And the umpire having a quick word with him.
A very good lift from Jarun Lei there. Flat lift. Wasn't really a chance for Tonto Wiamat to hit it steep enough. And then missed it. Totally.
So the 7-point cushion opened up once again. Make it 8 points now.
16-8.
Early on in that rally, Jang Nang more than stood his ground when his opponent was smashing 16. At him. Defensive shot, he absolutely took it so early. That one there, look at that! My goodness! Well, she doesn't miss many of those. Yeah, no wonder she's frustrated.
Service over.
17-9. So quick onto those half-court pushes, Jang Nang.
I think the Indonesians, they have to play the backcourt a little bit more. They cannot play all their shots to the front court, because the Chinese will overload that area. They get punished.
Pushed it wide. when you say more to the backcourt on the return of serve, you're not talking about lifting it, you're talking about a flatter push.
Yeah. And perhaps also in the rally, lifting it flat to the backcourt so they can still stand the ground in the defense, but gets sort of the whole court to play on, because right now both Zhao and Zhang are covering the front court really well. See if they can create some space in the midcourt.
Well, no wonder both the Chinese coaches applaud, because there's a lot of game point opportunities for Zhang Yang and Zhao Yunlei. Well, again, she's not happy with herself, but sometimes you just have to say, well, my opponent had a very good return of serve. Seeds the world and Olympic champions Zhang Nan and Zhao Yunlei. 21-10. And they really were very impressive indeed. Just 15 minutes for game number one. I'm not sure I ever remember Li Yongbo playing mixed doubles. He was such a tremendous men's doubles player. I remember seeing him play with men's singles. It's quite awesome. Well, it was very interesting, I think, in that 2-minute timeout that Novo Widianto, the Indonesian coach, we don't understand any Bahasa, but it was quite clear from his gestures that he was talking exactly the point that you have made, Steen, because he appeared to be saying, if you get a lift, get it deep. But he was urging them to get forward to the net, I'm sure of it.
Yeah, and the problem for the Indonesians is that now they play with the wind. Well, the drift here in the hall coming from the Indonesian side going towards the Chinese, so it's going to be harder for them to control their lifts on this side of the court. And of course, the second point you made, that they have to come forward after the lift, is crucial, because they can't win this match from the defense.
Yeah, that's what you were talking about. That's just wrong. Do you know, I thought there was a couple of opportunities in that rally, Steen, after they had played the deep lift, the shuttle deep in court, for Liliana Nasir to step forward, but she didn't. That's a great call, isn't it, by the line judge?
I think maybe the first game is still a little bit in her mind, or her body. The Indonesians were actually outplayed in the first game. So, as a coach, you often tell the players, well, we've lost the first game quite convincingly, so this is going to be a tough match. We cannot go from our sort of C game to our A game. We can't hope for that. We have to go to the B game first and then suddenly gain confidence. Ah!
He's certainly not afraid to leave his partner at the back of the court. Yang Nan stepped forward to dominate the net area. Of course, he will be playing in the men's doubles final, the last final of the afternoon.
I think he's been very impressive in this tournament, Yang Nan.
Yeah.
Actually, it's a brilliant move from the Chinese coaches playing him in men's doubles. I mean, he's only 25 years of age, and still he's won the World, the Olympics, the Asian Games. He's won everything in mixed doubles. I think he has a desire to play in the men's doubles and try to make a reputation for himself as perhaps the greatest doubles player of his era. So the motivational part of it is really, really brilliant in my opinion.
Yeah, very good point. It's simply too loose at the net for Liliana Nasir. Oh, great. Oh, it's just one of those. I'm going to say great defense.
Service over. 3-4.
Again, a challenge. The instant review system in operation here.
In.
Hawkeye will be asked to adjudicate. Players take the opportunity to towel down. Well, Zhao Yunlei actually spread her arms as the shuttle was landing, indicating that she thought it was out. It was called in.
My initial feeling was that it was in as well.
Well, the fans engaged by Hawkeye. Yeah, it was out. It was out by some considerable way. Badminton terms, that's not even close.
It's good they found the shuttle again.
It was me getting it all wrong yesterday. I'm going to send you to the opticians as well.
Yeah. I'm not going to play. I'm not going to try my luck anymore. Defense again by the Chinese pair. The quality of their defense means that Trontoviama doesn't get enough chances.
Play.
Or for that matter, Liliana Nasir doesn't get any chances to intercept.
Just missed it. Now that defensive shot from Zhang Nan, where he played that fast cross court towards the deep forehand corner of Tantowi Ahmad, that's the sort of shot that you've been wanting the Indonesians to do to the Chinese.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And they're particularly efficient against Tantowi Ahmad because he seems to be a little slow coming out of his forehand corner.
Well, I know it's hard work physically to keep smashing, keep taking the shuttle early, but that is the only way they're going to win.
And two very good shots from Tontovi Ahmad, after he hit the first one, cross-court, he knew that he was going towards his backhand corner. The only thing Deng Lang could do was lift straight.
Play, please.
Doesn't like the call again. Once again, Hawkeye is asked to adjudicate. Yeah, everybody gets engaged with Hawkeye, don't they? Fans love it on the giant screen. Even the coaches are smiling. And it really has been great for the sport of badminton. I'm not going to put you on the spot.
Thanks.
All right, was in. Yeah, one judge got it right.
Challenge unsuccessful.
And was Zhao Yonlai trying a little
Five,
bit to influence
seven.
The line judge
Zhao
there?
Zhao Yonlai and Zhao Yonlai have one challenge remaining.
I wasn't paying enough attention, but
she does have a habit of spreading her arms, doesn't she?
Waving a little bit.
Yeah, which can be perceived as trying to influence. Line judge.
I think it was a fault before.
Yeah, that landed out, but it touched his racket.
Seven.
Good umpiring, spotted it immediately. So now just 1 point in it.
Mid-court early in the rally. Ahmad caught him a little bit lifting, but this time no chance. Very efficient from Jim Han.
Just wide. What a real lesson in how to be positive on
Nine,
defense from
six.
Zhao Yonlai in that rally.
Zhao.
No, I think the umpire's going to have a word with Zhao Yonlai.
And they're totally fired up.
Yeah.
Jin Nan and Zhao Yonlai.
Play.
Is that because Li Yongbo is sitting in the coaching chair?
That's why I mentioned it so early in the match when we first got a glimpse of the fact that he was there, the head coach, and the importance of that, the influence
Ten,
of that.
Six.
Delightful Never change of pace from Zhao Yonlai. Well, a 5-point advantage now at the mid-game interval of game number two. It was a 6-point advantage in the opening game. But they really are looking, well, you said the word, fired up. They're looking sharp. Determined. Yeah, and I guess the confidence of the coaches, the fact of one quick word and they're back to the coaches' seats.
Yeah, and that's what I like about the coaching of Li Yongbo. He looks a firm believer in what he tells the players. There's no hesitation whatsoever. And then when your play backs it up, you just get really, really confident that you got this game right.
11-6. Play.
Tight spinning net shot on the return of serve.
7-11.
Now Natsir and Ahmad, they need to take a little bit bigger risks because otherwise they won't get into this game. So.
Just to explain that a little bit further, Steen, yeah. When you talk about taking risks, you're talking about taking the half chances rather than...
Yeah, and playing it a little bit sharper to the net, because what they've done so far is not working. It's not working well enough, at least. So you need to, I mean, this service situation, you need to create a bigger lift, a bigger chance on the return. And it could go horribly wrong so that they could get, like, 9 or 10 points also in this game, but in order to try and win it, they need to be doing something. They need to try to challenge the Chinese.
They're not playing for second best here.
No.
You know, it's an all-England final.
13,
and I must
7.
Say, I haven't seen Jiang Nan and Jiayun Lei play as well as this as since the Olympics. The message is you can try and play the net, but it's closed. I'm there.
Yeah.
Got it covered.
Reveal his state of mind.
Tantori.
No, he's going to be told off by the umpire here. Look at the frustration. There's nothing offensive about throwing the racket, but the umpire just saying, you know, just cool it.
Player. Taking too long to serve. Play must be continuous. Play late.
Taking too long to serve. Well, my reaction was that Liliana Nasir had moved before the serve was struck and that it was a fault receiver, but there we go. Now that's a good smash. He does tend to wait on that. Straight down the line there, waiting with a backhand defence. You can get it down his forehand side, it's often to your advantage. That again, I can tell you that the umpire allowed Jiayun Lei to go off and towel down, which doesn't seem to really coincide with his comment that she was taking too long to serve. Play must be continuous. That's a very, very good drive. Yeah, there's the coaches step forward, take the shuttle early.
16-9.
Look at this backhand. Look how close that was over the net. Virtually no backswing of the racket.
Exactly, no backswing. Just a very, very short, quick touch.
This time, he played the backhand across court. Generating power once again.
17-9.
think actually playing men's doubles might have improved his flat game, because you need to be fast when you play the men's doubles. You don't have as much time as mixed.
The lock of the net courts. Yeah, I think that's a very good point, actually, Steve. I think he has improved, just as we've seen other players in the women's doubles start playing mixed doubles to improve their net play. I think him playing the men's doubles with Fu Haifeng has really improved his sharpness around the mid-court area. Oh, great defence. And now the world and Olympic champions just 2 points away from a second All England title.
99.
Error on the return of serve, and that gifts match point,
20.
Championship
match
points.
Point.
To the world and Olympic champions. Totally outclassed the three-time defending champions Tung Toi Ahmad and Liliana Nasir.
21-10.
Symmetry in the scoreline. 21-10, 21-10. In just 37 minutes of play. You said they were sharp. You said that they were playing better than you'd seen them since they won the Olympic gold medal in London in 2012. I wouldn't disagree with that at all. They've won the title here at the 2015 Yonex All England Championships without dropping a game. Chinese obviously celebrating. It was a wonderful performance. Let's go courtside and let's have a word with our new All England champions.
Let's have a word about your opponents. They put up a strong challenge. They've had a great tournament, haven't they?
你们的队友这一届就是整个全球比较紧的挫折，对对对手比较有什么价吗？因为前面在关注自己的比赛，没有说去太关注对方，但是我想说决赛遇到就先打好自己的吧。 Actually, because I was focusing on playing my matches previously, so I didn't really notice the opponent's matches, but when I'm playing in the finals, I was really just focusing on trying to play the best. Well, congratulations to our champions, your next All England Open Mixed Doubles Champions of 2023, Zinedine!
They said they really tried to be focused, and I don't think that's an understatement. They really were so intense, so focused the whole way through from the very, very first rally. Well, the obvious delight, a second All England mixed doubles.
Ladies and gentlemen, time for the presentation for the mixed doubles club. Please show your appreciation to our presentation party, Jethro, President of Famitano, Paul Jensen, Managing Director of UXUK, and Adrian Christie, Chief Executive of Famitano. First, a presentation to our officials.
As All England champions, it comes to an end. But they should be proud of
the fourth consecutive final. Commemorative Snoopies from Paul Jensen, Managing Director of Yonex UK.
Second All England title for Zhang Nang and Zhao Yunlei. A third title in total for Zhao Yunlei, because of course she won the women's doubles in 2012.
And now the trophies will be awarded by Jethro, President of Badminton England.
Jethro, President of Badminton England, presents the trophies. 29th title for Zhang Nang and Zhao.
Ladies and gentlemen,
a 22nd Super Series title.
Mixed doubles winners from China, Zhang Nang and Zhao Yunlei. Thank you once again to our presentation party.
Well, it is a remarkable record
Snoopy,
this pair hold.
Do celebrate
when they formed their partnership in 2009. That was the only tournament, one tournament, the China Open that year. So really only been playing together since 2010. The 29th title together. And Steen, it really was a remarkable performance. They were so sharp right from the start.
Yeah, it seems like they had a really good game plan. Played quite even matches with Amad and Natsir. But this time they were clearly superior to the Indonesian pair.
So the players set off on their lap of honour. Thoroughly deserve their title this year. From the first round, their performance has been impeccable. Turn our attention now to women's singles, and history will be made today because a player from neither India or Spain has ever won the All England title. In fact, players from those two countries have never been in the All England finals. It is Saina Nawal, the Olympic bronze medalist, up against the European and world champion Carolina Marin.
It's time to welcome the players. Let's hear it for the number three seed from India, Saina Nawal!
Thank
a very serious-looking Simon Awell. The focus and the concentration.